Melodrama. In this video, I will be discussing melodramas written for pianist with narrator. I will not be going into the larger genre of theater, the one that portrays the lives of stereotypical stock characters experiencing very contrived situations in overly sensational plot lines, but I will instead focus specifically on melodramas written for pianist with narrator, for more intimate home parlor entertainments. Hello, I'm Anthony Olson, and in this video, I'll be discussing melodramas for piano with an actor or narrator. Piano player who regularly entertains friends and family at the keyboard, and you would like to spice up your evening entertainments, then melodrama is something you may wish to consider. A dramatic reading provides a unique offering for your evening guests. There is wonderful music written by well-known composers that accompanies excellent stories by great authors. Piano teachers looking into this literature will also find very wonderful gems that can enhance a studio recital. Narrations set to music allow piano students to collaborate with their non-musician friends and attracts a wider audience. Middle school and high school students, particularly boys, quickly engage with this music as it often depicts ghosts, medieval knights in shining armor, or wild animals. The melodrama first appeared in the mid-1700s. It was the brainchild of two individuals, Swiss composer, writer, and philosopher Jean-Jacques Rousseau, and Czech composer Georg Benda. Rousseau and Benda wrote several works for narrator with orchestra. And by the end of the century, this art form began to gain some popularity. Mozart was so enthusiastic about it, he began work on a full evening-length melodrama for actor with orchestra. But unfortunately, he never completed this work before his premature death. The late 18th and early 19th centuries saw melodrama become a key ingredient in operas. Beethoven even made use of it in his only opera, Fidelio. With the rise of popularity of the piano as the instrument of the home in the early 19th century, and dramatic readings a favorite parlor entertainment, the melodrama with piano was born. In the 1800s, a number of well-known composers tried their hand at composing a melodrama. The repertoire is not vast. There are about a dozen or so works by famous composers of the 19th and early 20th centuries, and about another dozen or so pieces by more obscure musicians. With the immense popularity of both the piano and dramatic readings as home entertainment during this time period, it is actually a little surprising how few of these works have been left to us today. One of the first melodramas written for piano was composed by Franz Schubert. Schubert wrote a number of melodramas with orchestra, but only one for the piano. Dating from 1826, the work is entitled Farewell, Beautiful Earth, and lasts about 2 minutes. It is a simple and poignant farewell to life. The text reflects a peaceful Christian worldview of one looking forward to joy in the afterlife. Schubert's music mirrors the text in the peaceful mood that it creates. It's in a major key with very consonant harmonies with a slow undulating triplets. And it is an excellent choice for any intermediate level pianist. The piece offers few technical challenges and can be mastered relatively quickly.
Farewell, beautiful earth. Only now do I understand you. as joy and sorrow pass from view.
Robert Schumann wrote three works for speaker and piano. He wrote all three late in his life, and the texts Schumann chose fall into our cliched notion of melodrama. Castle life, stormy nights, and ghostly apparitions. The pieces are interesting and well worth exploring. The piano heightens the text in much the same way it contributes to the mood and drama in his songs. It provides regal fanfare for the night in his castle in Fair Hedwig. The haunts of phantoms in the Ballad for the Heath Boy. And the noise of the storm in the melodrama The Refugees. These pieces are a bit more difficult than Schubert's melodrama, but are still within the very doable category for most piano players, those with late intermediate or early advanced keyboard skills.
When, soft, a lovely maid draws near and fills his goblet high. Then steps aside with modest fear. Her face illumined with blushes like morning's rosy sky.
Franz Liszt, in his melodramas, lived up to his reputation as the ultimate romantic. Liszt wrote five melodramas with piano, choosing even gorier poetry than had Robert Schumann. In his most substantial and lengthy setting, he uses the poem by Gottfried August Berger. And I likely butchered the pronunciation of that name. My apologies to Mr. Berger. Berger's extended ballad, Leonore, was a favorite parlor reading in the 18th and 19th centuries. And the best English translation of this poem is by Sir Walter Scott. Sir Walter Scott was enthralled by the poem when he first encountered it and worked through the night on a paraphrase translation that he entitled William and Helen. The story harkens back to the time of the Crusades. It tells of a lady whose lover failed to return from war. In her despair, she blasphemes and curses God for her ill fate. But in the middle of the night, her lover returns and takes her away on horseback. But during the ride, it becomes clear that her knight in shining armor is actually a ghastly harbinger of death in disguise. There is a large amount of Liszt-ian pianism to enjoy in this work. Musical depictions of marching soldiers, heart-wrenching emotional despair, and galloping horse on a wild ride through the night, as well as ghastly apparitions of death. This work falls into the category of do not try this at home, folks. It has a number of passages that demand serious piano skills, and unless you're a very advanced player, please do not try this at home.
Tramp, tramp along the land they rode. Splash, splash along the sea. The scourge is white, the spur is bright, the flashing pebbles flee. Fled past on right and left, how fast each forest, grove, and bower. On right and left fled past, how fast each city, town, and tower. Dost fear? Dost fear? The moon shines clear. Dost fear to ride with me? Hurrah! Hurrah! The dead can ride!
Of all Liszt's melodramas, The Sad Monk is by far the most unique. It is a setting of a poem of a knight in shining armor who stops at a haunted castle for the evening. In creating the mood of the ghost who haunts this castle, Liszt uses harmonies based on whole tone scales and augmented chords. The effect is truly stunning, and the piece sounds more like something written decades later by impressionistic composers. The harmonies are far more advanced than anything written or even imagined by composers of the mid-19th century. This piece is another excellent choice for any piano player who has late intermediate or early advanced keyboard skills. It is also an excellent piece for piano teachers looking for an interesting assignment for a precocious middle or high school student. The work poses few technical challenges, allowing the player to quickly focus on collaborating with their narrative partner.
Thus rain poured down. A rider neared. He spurred his steed continue on. He'd lost his path in twilight's dim, immured in thought, oblivious. The wind did howl within the woods like children beaten, keen to God.